I'm detecting an alarming level of chronoton emissions in the general vicinity. Are any of you time travelers?
I think I'm from the future. Does that count?
I put Edgar and Poe in a headlock one time. That was pretty cool.
I kind of fell into the 14th century once, but that was totally not my fault.
Time travel. Let me see. Well, Max and I went back to ancient Egypt, visited our teenage selves, quizzed our ancient creaky selves, mind-melded with our great-grandfathers,
accidentally created a pair of temporal clones,
fought a trio of time-traveling mariachis, and, oh yeah, messed around with the beginning of time once or twice. Does that count?
Congratulations. You're a universe-imperiling paradox in dog's clothing. Commencing chronoton sterilization. Now.
Ooh, tingly. Wait, did you say sterilization?
Chronotons eliminated. Continuity restored to 78% plausibility.
I like those odds.
You hear they're doing a movie version of Who's the Boss?
Son of a bitch!
Why can't Hollywood let our childhood icons die a dignified death, instead of parading them around like rotting zombies?
Or, you know, at least have the creative cojones to do some sort of ironic pastiche thing instead of just pissing all over the original material. Damn it! Judith Light deserves better!
We never watched the original. Catherine Hellman's smile gave Max seizures.
So, Sam, what's next for Telltale?
Beats me. Max and I are just happy someone touched up our models.
I've never felt so comic booky.
Dean keeps telling me that they're gonna do something with a menage. Whatever the hell that is.
You know what I always thought would make a good video game? Viva freaking Las Vegas. Elvis, race cars, gambling, and Margaret.
And Elvis was a black belt, so you got the whole karate angle, too.
You see what I mean? It's a guaranteed blockbuster.
Elvis? Nope, never heard of him. I've been thinking about growing some hair.
You can do that?
I can't, but Dr. Zed, back on Pandora, he says he could set me up with a full head of wavy black hair. Just like some guy back on Earth called Elvis. They guess you go for it?
You can't go wrong rocking it like the king.
I don't know, man. It's hard to trust a bald guy who suddenly has hair. Rusty wore a hairpiece for a while. I kept thinking he'd been replaced by his evil twin.
Besides, hair's overrated. All that combing and powdering, who needs it? And don't even get me started on the ticks and chiggers. This one time I got a nest of fleas burrowed so far up my...
Stop!
Sorry.
Guys!
Are you stuck in a loop again?
No! I just realized that the four of us represent the four pillars of geek media! Movies, television, comics, video games!
I was in comics? How embarrassing.
It's not so bad.
Guys, you're missing the big picture! The four of us should get together and form a multimedia conglomerate! Like HB Warner Time, or just Marvel Filmelodeon!
I don't think that's such a good idea. Those Cartoon Network lawyers can be pretty... rough.
And MGM promised to cross me over with James Bond someday.
Besides, I thought you liked working for, Shoebox?
Gearbox? Those dilweeds? Let me tell you something. Gearbox is the best video game company in the world, bar none. They treat their employees with dignity, respect, and, yes, love. Also, I am a total tool. With the rusty salad fork, know what I mean? Didn't you guys have a big election around here a few months ago?
Don't remind me.
Hey, who'd you vote for?
It's called a secret ballot for a reason, Diebold Head.
I voted to re-elect President Superball. I like a commander-in-chief who's enigmatic and glowy.
I didn't vote.
Dude! Lame! If you don't vote, you can't whine!
I was gonna vote, but on election day, this horde of deadites showed up at my polling place. And by the time I was finished with all the horde repelling, the polls were closed.
Well, that doesn't seem fair.
It's probably just as well. I was gonna flip a coin anyway.
Okay, quick topic. Words to live by. Go!
Life is short and sadistic, so make love to it like a one-eyed double agent.
Always run in the opposite direction of loud noises!
There's always time for more science.
Never go anywhere without written instructions. What about you?
Mine was try not to be a jerk, but I'm really liking that thing about the sadistic midgets. I don't know about you guys, but I love living in the 21st century. Pull-top soup cans, resealable bags of shredded cheese, obese criminals who obligingly wear their pants below their behinds for easy tripping. It's a golden age.
And what about the medical stuff? They're making pills that unleash tiny robots into your arteries. How awesome is that?
Robots, schmobots. At S-Smart, we've started selling these jackets that dry themselves when they get wet.
Oh, you guys are gonna be so bummed when the robot invasion comes.
Aw, dang. I just caught myself thinking about thinking again.
Oh, metacognition spirals. Nasty.
Is that where you keep staring at your hands while your internal volume is cranked up to 11?
That sounds more like a stroke.
Walk into the light!
Whoops, I guess it was just gas. My eyes are up here, Ash.
I'm just trying to figure out why you wear pants and your buddy over there doesn't.
Max says he likes the feel of the wind against his unspeakable nether regions.
Him and me both, brother. Whee!
Well, there goes my libido for a week.
But why do you wear pants, Sam?
Because they match my jacket.
Never mind.